welcoming me to your living room. This is Baraka Muganda on behalf of Sola Fide Church. Today, our topic is Give Your Tears to God. Crushed in soul, Hannah prayed to God and cried inconsolably. Then she made a vow, O God of the angel armies, if you take a good, hard look at my pain, if you quit neglecting me and go into action for me by giving me a son, I'll give him completely and unreservedly to you. I'll set him apart for a life of holy discipline. 1 Samuel 1, verse 10, 11, in the book, the Bible, the Message. Lots of women in the Bible had the painful life of sharing a husband with another wife. And the men of them also faced the pain of having no children. Today, many people are sorrowful because they can't have children. But in those days, it was worse in one way. Women who couldn't have children, it was always the women's fault, were seen as inadequate or even cursed by God. So the men would take another wife, and often she would have children. But she wouldn't be as loved, and she would ignore it. And her secret and happiness would lead her to follow the childless wife and make her life a misery. The story was repeated over and over. This was Hannah's situation. But Hannah knew what to do about it. She took her pain and tears to God. She cried and prayed. And of course, we know the story, how Hannah begged for a son and promised to dedicate him to God. And God did send Samuel to her, and then several other children as well. But here is the real question. Was Hannah comforted just by praying, even if her request was not granted? I think she was. I think in verse 18, when you read it, it says, when Eli said, go in peace, and Hannah went and ate heartily, her face radiant, her heart was already at peace, no matter what God's answer would be. Can we do that? Is there something you've been begging God for? Some situation you pray so hard over and don't know if it will turn out as you hope it will? When you go to God about it and pour out your heart, do you seek His peace and His presence? Or do you just seek the answer you want? Do you then go and tell your friends, I don't know what God will say or do, but I feel better having talked to Him about it? Or if it doesn't turn out as you hope, do you say, God didn't answer my prayer? God answers every prayer. He doesn't grant every request. There is a difference. May we all learn it. Today, God is a peacemaker. When I am in conflict, remind me that you are nearby. God, tell God when I'm longing for some certain outcome. Of course, I hope you grant my request. But if you don't, help me remember that I'm always, always your precious child. And if you can't give me what I ask, you can always, always give me yourself, your presence, your peace. Like Hannah, that's what I truly long for. May God bless you as you go through your day.